Hello everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Autism's Minecraft server with me, of course, AutismsDad. And today we are back at the water mill again. I know, I've been like here at the water mill for like a million gazillion episodes, but I kind of like it here. Yeah, I think it's coming along really well. It looks absolutely fan-dabby-dozy. And I just want to keep expanding it. I want to keep making it into a really cool area. And I think we're on that right track. So I want to keep the momentum and I want to keep on doing it. So what I'm going to do is right behind me, actually, I am going to build the most amazing thing in the world. Okay, it's the most technically difficult, absurdly fantastic, amazing thing ever. And it's a first on YouTube. Oh, yes, it is a first on YouTube. We are going to build a cattle farm. Oh, yes, a cattle farm. Okay, fine. There you go. There's about 10 people I've lost and subscribers. But the point is that what we're going to do is we're going to expand the farm field. You know, we've got the wheat. We can make bread. What else can we do with wheat? We can breed cattle. And what comes with cattle and cows and all that good stuff? No, not excellent conversation, but what comes is steak, people. Oh yeah, steak. And I love steak. That is the one thing that I liked about, you know, this server. When we started this server, there was lots and lots of cows around. So what we're going to do is we're going to do something a bit different here. Well, I could do one of two things, actually. I could build a, you know, a big square area with, you know, rails and fences, and just fill it with cows. And whoopee-doo, we've got ourselves a cow farm. Brilliant. Or I could build one of those like amazing one block wide full of redstone and makes me a steak when I'm asleep type things. Or I could do something a bit cooler than that, because I quite like both elements to that. I like the fact that you can generate, you know, with a bit of, you know, game mechanics. I like the fact that you can manipulate some game mechanics to get cows, you know, breeding, you know, a bit quicker in an easier area, in a more manageable way. I like that. But what I also like is I like them wandering around in a pen. You know, I like it. I love it. I love coming over and I love watching them while they look at each other and look at you and just go, murr. I love it. I think it's really cool and it adds to the nature of the game. So, how are we going to do it? Where are we going to do it? I'm going to do it here. This is why I'm lollygagging around here, right? I want to do it here. Now, what I am going to do is I'm going to square the area out a little bit. I'm not going to go too encroaching into the river, but what I am going to do is I'm going to sort of, you know, make it out to about here, because actually this area in front of us right now, I want to dig all of that out because I want to make a barn. Yeah, I want to put a barn right there, and the barn's going to be a cool farmyard barn. Maybe we'll use a couple of these doors again, you know, how we made these doors on it, but essentially it's going to be a cow barn, a cattle barn, whatever, and we're going to be able to you know, have the cows in front. But we're going to do a little mechanism where you can breed the cows in an area inside the barn, and then it will move the younger cows. What do you call them? Oh, calves. That's what you call them, calves. So we're going to move the calves and we're going to move them out of the barn into the pen area where all the cows will be, you know, will be. So, and living their life of luxury. So, and then when they get older, then we can just come in and, you know, gently take their steak, which isn't probably that gentle, but we're going to do that. That's what we're going to do. Because I love steak. I love bread. And maybe we can have bread, steak, steak sandwiches. I love steak sandwiches. So that's what we're going to do. So that's a long enough intro. Now, oh my goodness me, I have got to dig out all this area and take down these trees. Well, I'll put up one of Big H's brand new songs for you to listen to while I take, you know, probably about, well, in your time while you're watching this video, probably about 45, 60 seconds. But I hope you enjoy it. Take care, guys. See you in a minute. Okay, guys, it's been a lot longer than 60 seconds, I can tell you, because I didn't finish it up today or yesterday, actually, when I was when I did the first part of this episode, this first part recording, and I logged on today to continue the episode, and look what I've got in front of the barn. This is my house. This is what Blue is making me in the town center. I just don't know how he comes up with these ideas. I really don't. Look at the detail on this house. What I like about it is the two viewing areas, the windows there. How cool is that? I love the fact that it's two different styles as well. And look how simplistic it looks. It follows the roof around, and then he's just simply put two fence posts there just to define it. It's really, really good. And this whole area is just coming together so well. It's crazy, absolutely crazy. Anyway, on with the show. And I do believe he's doing a couple of recordings as well on that. So please jump over and have a look how he did it and how he came up with things. He said it was a lot of trial and error, I believe. But as you can see, it's so effective. Even the two windows are at different levels, which I like as well, but it still follows the roof, you know, and that's what I like most about it. That's what I think is pretty, you know, pretty darn cool about the way Blue comes up with these ideas for the buildings. Anyway, let's carry on with this one. So, as we talked about last time, we're going to... I thought I did all. I've left a single line. As we talked about before, we're doing a an area here for a barn to go with the farm feel of this area, but we're also wanting an area for the cattle to just wander around. And this is what I'm going to do here in front of the barn, or the would-be barn. But first, I'm actually going to map this out already with fence posts, because I think the first task I want to do is to start to get some cattle. And the reason why I want to start to get some cattle is because we can continue to grow the herd, as it were, by giving them wheat and getting more cattle whilst we're building this project, Yeah, so whilst we're over building this project, we can just every now and again come over and feed the cattle and get them breeding. And I think this is something that I think is going to be we're going to be thankful of this, I think, when we're by the end of this episode, because otherwise we're just going to end up waiting around. If we can get some cattle it already, you know, a good sizable number, then I think we're halfway there in the battle, aren't we? So I'm gonna punch out a couple of areas to put some gates. I've got a couple of gates here, so I have an access point there for now, I mean, and then we'll have an access point over this side as well, just because we need to get in there. Because now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and find some cattle. Yeah, wish me luck. In fact, actually, I don't need much luck because I know where one is immediately. Because when I was over having a look at what Blue was doing and having a chat to Blue, there's a cow right by the house, by the new house. So hopefully he's still going to be there. Or she. I hope it is a she, because we need to breed them. Did I plant all that? Yes, I did. And let's go and find me that cow. Yes, there he is. I told you he was around here somewhere. There he is. Hello, Mr. Cow. Oh, don't walk away from me. I've got something for you. Oh, yes. Yes, there we go. Yes, is this going to be our first cow? Yes. And now we're going to have our first cow. And just because you followed me, I'm going to give you some wheat, because you're a nice cow. Open the gate. Shut the gate. Sorry, you've got no one else to love. I'm going to get you someone to love now, okay? Okay, guys. We're going to witness it. We're going to witness love, pregnancy, and birth in about 3 seconds. Ready? Boom. Boom. Yay, there he is. Hello, little man. You can have some wheat as well. I know it's not going to do much, but you can have it. Right then, we've pushed it back a little bit. I say we, I have. And I just realized that there's a little like pond or riverbed here, which is really cool. I can see a little bit of clay as well out there that I need. Where's this bat come from? Oh, I know where this bat comes from. This bat has come from down here. Look. There's a cave. But I don't want to get distracted. I love going caving in Minecraft. I think it's fantastic. But anyway, let's sort this out. What are we going to do? What are we going to do? Right. I'm going to count over these blocks a minute, because I think that's quite wide. So I might need to take it in a couple, but let's have a count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. It's an even. Do we like even? I think we might like even. So 16 across is gonna be quite a monstrous thing. So I'm gonna shorten it, but if that's 16, then we're gonna go 15, 14. So if I go there, and then I come in 2 from there, that's gonna be 12 now, isn't it? Let's do that. Let's stick to 12. And let's take this all down, like so. And we can start it up again from this one. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do like a barn, look and feel to it. And I am gonna use, as I said before, I am gonna use some clay blocks. Let's get around to these chests over here, because I've still got quite a bit of clay. What are you doing in here? What are you doing in here? You don't eat bread. Look at you, you're skinny. So here we go. Let's have a look out here. I was thinking of doing something with stone, you see, bricks, sorry, not just any old stone, but bricks. We got some clay, a little bit of clay there. Let's just get rid of some of this junk. Just keep the wheat with me. So what have we got? What have we got, ladies and gentlemen? Yes, I haven't got much clay going on in there. And we've only got a few bricks. I used a lot in there on the other, wheat farm. There's a blair, couldn't get my words out then. I'm going to take hardened clay and red clay and green clay. Okay. Now, bear with me on this, because I'm thinking that this barn, oh, more stairs. I think this barn thing might look good with some hardened clay, but we'll see. We'll see how good it is. I want to see what it looks like with the dark oak. So let's go and have a look. Oh man, look at this house. It looks amazing. Right then, so let's go over here and let's go. We're going to go up four on these pillars. So basically what's happening is that I'm going to have this area from this post to this post. This fence won't be here. Yeah, so it'd be like a wall and maybe a barn door there, like a sliding barn door. And then all this will be contained as well inside the barn. So all the cows, they can come in and go out. You know, it's fine. It's absolutely fine. So that's what I'm going for here. So don't think I'm boxing this all in, because I'm not. So let's go up four. That's what we're going to do. And one, two, three, four. There like that. And then I'm not going to do like an inset wall like I've done here. You see where I've come in one from the post? I've come in a block. I'm not going to do that for the barn, because, you know, barns are quite, you know, they're not insulated buildings. They don't need thickness or anything like that. So I'm just going to count it out, and I'm going to have, I do like this wooden frame though, this timber frame. So that's what I'm going to try and continue with here. So let's just bring it all out like this. Dong, dong, dong. Like this. Don't go too far. Let's just cut it there. Now, as you can see, I just did that in the wrong place. As you can see, I don't really count it out much. Do you know what I mean? I'm not really one for doing things like that. I count it out after, like now, and realize that it's not an odd and I can't put a pillar in the middle. But let's have a look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Cool! So 17, so we're going, what's the middle number? 8. No? Yes. No. 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I'm going to punch him out. And I'm going to go between you two guys. Is that okay? Yes. Done. There we are. Happy days. Let's do this. Right, and now we're going to do one area in green. Oh, should we do green? No, let's do hardened clay on this area here, like this. What is going on? Oh, I like that. Yeah, I do like that. That looks cool. That looks cool. Let's do at the top as well and just see what happens there. Oh, you know what? Hardened clay looks really good with the brown, with the dark oak, doesn't it? So now let's do red. Why am I putting it in the wrong place? Let's just come all the way out like this. Oh, you know what? I like red. I love red. So I think I'm going to do red, but to confirm this feeling, I'm just going to put it there. Oh yeah, it looks cool. Yeah, red it is. Okay, so now I'm going to do the back and sides and the front with red. I need to go back to my humble abode, to my tower base by the community house, to get some red dye. And we've got Big H's a dye farm, yeah? So I'm just going to have to go over and do that because I need a lot more blocks of clay, red clay anyway. Okay, people, I've been digging, shoveling, doing whatever, and getting loads of clay. I need loads of clay because I've decided what I'm going to do. I've decided what I'm going to do for the barn. And what I'm going to do for the barn is, I'm going to use brick, as I've said before. I'm going to use brick because I think it's going to look really cool with the red and with the brown. And if I show you sort of what I mean, bring yourself, Cal. Yeah. Certainly for the edge of the roof, I'm gonna do it like this, I think. Yeah, so I'm just gonna do it like that, and yeah, I think that'll work out quite well. I quite like the colours. In fact, I'm not gonna do it around the blocks that way, but you get the drift. That's the colours I'm going for. Not for the whole roof, mind you. It's gonna be wood. So it's going to be a timber roof, but it's going to be framed in this brick, yeah? And that's sort of the look I'm trying to go for. So I'll bring you back when it stops raining, because it's a nightmare doing me head in. Okay, I managed to cook up most of the clay that I had, and I've now got my stone bricks and stone brick stairs. Probably need to make some more stone brick stairs, but just want to get the frame of the roof first. That's something I want us to concentrate on now. Now the way I'm going to do it, as I sort of alluded to a little bit just a minute ago, is I want to use these red bricks, and I want it to look cool, you know, obviously, and I want it to look as though it's a barn feel. So I want a big swoop in, like at the top of an egg shape. Yeah, that's what I want to try and do for the roof at the top. And the way that I'm going to do that is a mixture of stairs and blocks, okay, to try and get that. And this is a bit of a trick, actually, I've noticed. This is a bit of a trick when we come to doing these types of tall high roofs. Now we do two stairs, so it sort of has, this is a top stair, that's a bottom stair, and then on the top stair we do a block, and then on the top of the block we do a stair like this, and then on the back of this stair we do a top stair. Yeah, so you sort of see it gradually coming up and up and up. And again, we do this here, we put that there, we do a stair, we do a top stair on the back of that one, yeah? And then we just basically keep that going. Now, I don't want to go too far because, you know, we're going to end up with a very high building. So we're probably going to cut it off soon as I feel I'm getting to the middle. I want to leave two flat blocks for the middle, so we'll probably just leave it there for now. Let me kill this zombie. Eat this. Okay guys, I just trimmed up the top, and yes, I am much happier now. And as I said, I want it to look like an egg, or the top of an egg, and I think it looks quite like the top of an egg, albeit an egg made of brick. Welcome back, guys. I've got a creeper on the port bow. See ya. We're back at night. I've taken the opportunity to come back at night because, quite frankly, it's been raining non-stop all the time, and it's very difficult to get a time when we can actually do some building. So I've come back now. We're just adding some detail. I've blocked up this bit in the rain, and this is our entrance. We'll do the same cover up the back. We'll do red brick again, or red clay. I'm running low on red clay. I need some more. But here we're going to do some little bit of detail in the front, because I think that from a distance it would be nice to have some sort of detail in it, and I think we can add this quite easily, quite frankly, just with some, you know, just some wooden blocks really. We're not going to do anything fancy. We're just going to put some recesses in this area. Maybe put a balcony across it as well, with some slabs. So let's do this here. I can't believe how many times I keep falling. I'm so bad at building on scaffolding. I don't know how I survive half the time. Just constantly falling. So just a couple of little places where we're gonna do a bit of detail like this. So that comes straight across there like that. I tell you what, maybe we could knock, have we got any bricks? Yes, we can knock this block out for a, not this stair out, I mean, for a block. That sort of finishes that. And we'll do the same this side. Bang, bang, like that. And then let's go up. Move. Move. Let's go up to a dump like this. And I'm going to go... Oh, we had a little opening there, so I need to go and knock that out there. So let's just do this nice and quick, and we'll go block, block like that. That's a nice little bit of detail, and then we're going to go slab, 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 and then take this down and go and have a look, and then we can realize that it's so bad, but I'm sure it's fine. Look at all the cows we've got on our cow farm. There you go, nice and easy, just really simple, bit of detail, and yeah, that's nice and easy. In fact, actually, what's this spruce fence? We've got a dark, yeah, it's got a dark fence. Just had a spontaneous idea. Maybe if we go boom, boom, like that. Yeah, that looks cool. That looks okay. Yeah, that looks okay. There you go, nice and easy. And now we need to fill in the roof. Right then, guys, just as the sun comes up over the AMS server, I give you the cow barn. Yes, the cow barn. Let's take it all in and have a look. I'll give you a couple of seconds. There's enough. Now, it's not finished. We've got lots to do. I've used some spruce bush, leaves to act like bushes. And obviously it's an old barn, so it's covered in stuff. So that's what I've done there. Put a nice little window in the side. Where are you? Stop growling at me, Mr. Zombie, wherever you are. Now, this, I like the red and I like the dark oak. I think they go really well together. So I'm really pleased about that. But look how many cows I've got. I've actually turned the sound for friendly mobs down, completely down, because, well, to about like 5% or something like this, because it's just, it's all very well when I started this saying, oh, I love to see the cows wandering around and mooing, but yeah, gets quite annoying. So I've turned their volume right down. But anyway, in here is where we are going to build the sort of machiney area that will give us a nice spot just to come over, because you know how manic it can get. So if I demonstrate this now, I get some wheat. Look how manic it gets now when I try and make these cows. I'll just like come out here and it's like, they're streaming in at me. Look at them. I don't know whether I've hit them. I don't know whether I've got their, you know, given them some wheat, and before I know it, it's all gone. And yeah, I don't know. I haven't got a clue. So we want mainly this area to be the area where we come in with a flame sword, you know, on it, or fire. What is it called? Fire something. Yeah, and flame is the one for, yeah, flame one is for the bow. Can you have flame one on a sword, or is it called something else? Anyway, you get my picture, you get my point, and then you can come over and you can take a cow out. Can you take a cow out with a flame one arrow and get steak? Oh, mate, you've just walked the wrong way. No, it doesn't do cooked steak. I get the steak. So I think it gets cooked steak when you hit it with a sword. And that's what we're gonna do, but we're gonna do a breeding area inside. So there you go, but I think it's coming together well. I really like it. Now I said I was going to do a shout out actually at this the end of the episodes. Now we're getting a lot of comments coming in from some really, really wonderful people. I need to, you know, some of the things that I want to talk about, man, I'm telling you, it's like I've got goosebumps on my arms because they're so, you know, really, really moving sort of comments and stuff from really, really inspiring people. But I think those people, I probably need to check with first before I start putting the comments out. But there's one that was actually done very recently, and it's quite good actually, because it gives me an opportunity to talk about what my point is to all this. And it's actually a comment by Cody Bush, and they say, you are a good person, thank you very much, you live to help and you keep it up, I hope you get $7 billion and become the greatest person in history. Well, Cody, I really appreciate your comments, as I do all of you, as I've said before. The reason why I picked this one today is because, you know, it gives me an opportunity to talk about why I'm doing all of this and what the point of this all is, because I get asked this all the time. I have no interest in personal gain from this. This is like my, you know, I know a lot of YouTubers out there, you know, they do this for a living and they're raking in the money and all the rest of it. But as I've always said, 100% of anything I get from YouTube for doing these videos will be going towards autism awareness. Without a doubt, anything I can do to reinforce that you know, awareness campaign of mine is what I'm striving for. Now the reason why I picked this one is because it says $7 billion. Now wow, I don't know how much that is in pounds from where I'm from, but it's still a lot of money. And I've always said, you know what, I've always wanted to win the Euro Millions, yeah, to win the lottery. And the only reason I want to do that for is because my ambition in life is to actually build and create a school in my home city dedicated to autism, yeah, for ages from, you know, 6 to, you know, 25. And the reason why I want to do that is because I want to build like a really huge, amazing school, but also have other things around the campus, like shops, and have sponsors from, you know, other people and like companies that would come in and have like, I don't know, like charity clothes shop or something. And the parents of autism, you know, of the kids can come in, they can donate, they can buy, they can whatever. And the same with the supermarkets as well. Like maybe we get a big supermarket sponsor and we build like a big, you know, sort of a little, you know, shop there as well. But my point is that every single shop there is run and employs everyone from the school that's like grown up from the school. Yeah, so not only can they have their educational experience, but as they go, they can you know, work in the stores on the campus and stuff like that, in the coffee shops and all things like that, just to give them some really cool life skills after they're, you know, 18 years old. They can still work at the school in a place where they feel secure and happy and stuff. And Cody, it's probably, you know, it's something that's quite prevalent in America, I understand. And, you know, it's these types of concepts that we just don't see in the UK, you know. But $7 billion for me, yep, that would allow me to do it, create a massive, brilliant model for that, and to replicate that throughout the country. So that's why I've chosen your comment today, Cody. And I really appreciate it. And I hope I can give you guys an idea of certainly where I'm from and what I want to do for this. As always, guys, I really appreciate you watching and taking the time to subscribe. Give us comments on the show, see if you like this, and if you've got any ideas for a bit more character or whatever for the cow barn, that would be great. And as always, take care, guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.